A Filipino-American entrepreneur is making strides in the field of artificial intelligence technology. John Tagala tells us more about Opai.ai, the market's newest household AI assistant.
This is just an incredible moment that we're coming together, not only for the Asian American community, but really for our whole country.
Care.com founder and former CEO Sheila Marcello continues to innovate in the care space to make life easier for families. This time, the Filipino-American, dubbed as a revolutionary problem solver, has created an AI-powered virtual assistant called O that will help households stay organized and help keep a work-life balance.
And every morning, your assistant will be named O, and she wakes you up and says, oh, hi there. How is your day like? And she goes through your scheduling, your calendar, make sure that we're solving conflicts for your family so that we can remove the cognitive load and the administrative task that moms, especially moms and chief household officers, take on that make their everyday difficult.
Marcello says it's like having Alexa or Siri that can actually integrate those products and do things for the user. It can manage schedule using a digital calendar and delegate tasks to lighten the mental load for whoever is the household chief.
It's got programs similar to Alexa and Siri, but we can actually integrate with those products to make it super easy. On average in the United States, families have kids of two or more, and so that makes it very difficult to coordinate. And then putting a nutritious meal on the table when you're leaving work and you're running out of time. So everything is just an overload for families.
Basic tier is free with limited capabilities such as getting a daily schedule summary and calendar alert. For a monthly subscription of $25, users can scan text, emails, and other documents to create calendar events automatically, as well as delegate tasks to family members and make appointments by phone.
So everything is just an overload for families, and our goal is to actually create a Zen experience to give families back time, quality time, as well as to say that they are not alone, and we at Opai.ai is here to support.
Opai.ai is available on smartphones and other digital devices via text messaging or via the Opai.ai website. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.
Opinion is split on the use of generative artificial intelligence in the music industry. While some see it as another tool to make music, others are pushing back.
Using artificial intelligence to make music is a topic that has divided opinions in the industry.
It's never going to replace live music.
It's absolutely not going to go away.
I don't like it. We don't like it.
Thanks to recent groundbreaking technological advances, generative AI can already produce original sounds, lyrics, or entire songs on its own. Robots are now making music as digital pop stars, while existing artists often use simpler AI to enhance their sound. As the technology continues to develop, will AI mean the death of original music or herald a new era of creativity? Inside this studio at London's Queen Mary University, music meets cutting-edge tech. PhD student Max Graf showcases Nets, a virtual instrument played by wearing an augmented reality headset, which tracks hand movements to create corresponding outputs like notes or chords. While Andrea Mortanelli fiddles with the hitar, an advanced guitar with AI sensors, which read movements to make drum and synthesizer sounds.
The way it works is that it's got a little bit of like a simple artificial intelligence that tracks whether you're coming down with a heel or you're coming down with the fingers, and it's consistent all across the body. So if you have different techniques, if you have different percussive techniques, you can all use them.
While artists have used technology for creative purposes since the 1950s, the use of AI, like Nets and the hitar, could be the newest tool to experiment with music. Speaking to Reuters, UK alternative rock artist Youngblood believes AI could be a tool for his music.
It allows me to get another space of inspiration or like another way of thinking. I think it's never going to replace live music, I think, and That's mainly the way I lead from. So like, I'll use it in a scenario where I'll be able to take a beat off a track, or I'll be able to pull a guitar line off a track to take me to another direction.
Other musicians, like alternative rock duo the Nova Twins, disagree.
I don't like it. We don't like it. I feel like you need AI to help you write a song, or especially when it's for a likeness. That's not cool.
The technology has recently seen the return of the Beatles, featuring the voice of John Lennon extrapolated with AI from an old recording. Warner Music has also signed a deal to recreate the voice of late French singer Edith Piaf. While labels and streaming companies partner to market the technology, many experts say AI raises legal or ethical concerns, especially when generative AI regulation is still in early stages. Abbas Lightwala is the director of global legal policy at the International Federation of the Phonographic Industry.
The sort of problem that we've faced is that there have been a real proliferation of AI developers who have trained AI models with large-scale amounts of copyright works without actually getting any authorization for doing so, and then using those tools to generate new content that actually competes with the very works that they've misappropriated.
So what does the future look like for AI in the music industry? Dr. Mathieu Barthé is a senior lecturer at Queen Mary University for digital media.
I think AI can have its place in the music production chain, again, if it's guided in the right way, and if we ensure that the musicians keep a certain amount of control, and performers as well.